بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We begin our third part of the revision من مراجعة الهيكل الصف العاشر. And now we start with these questions which are from module 13 lesson 1 اللي هو الدرس التعلم الذاتي. Okay, so compare the properties of suspensions, colloids and solutions. So these pages, هذا كله نظري. And also describe the electrostatic forces in colloids, اللي هو سؤال رقم 15, these pages, okay? So, to do that, let's go and explain a little bit about this section of from the book, okay? So we have different types of mixtures, المخاليط, which you studied in grade 8 in science, probably. So we have heterogeneous mixtures, mixtures in which the different materials can be distinguished easily. So heterogeneous, يعني how can I say that in Arabic? Yeah, so in Arabic, heterogeneous means غير متجانس. Okay? And homogeneous means متجانس. So what's the difference between heterogeneous and homogeneous mixtures? In heterogeneous, you can directly see what are the different components. شو الأجزاء المختلفة. You can تفرقهم بسهولة, distinguish them easily. Homogeneous mixtures, it has a uniform appearance throughout the solution or the mixture itself. صعب إن احنا نقدر نفرق ما بين الأجزاء بس بمجرد النظر يعني. Okay? Just by looking. So examples of heterogeneous mixtures are sand with water. So if you look at sand with water or mud, الطين, مي مع رملة يعني, you can tell that there is water and there is sand, right? You can distinguish, نقدر نفرق ما بينهم, غير متجانس, مخلوط غير متجانس. But a homogeneous mixture is seawater. There is salt and water. Can you know just by looking? ما نقدر نعرف بمجرد النظر, لازم ندوق. صح؟ And then you will know it's actually water and salt. So this is the difference between these two types of mixtures. Okay? So what are some of the types of heterogeneous mixtures, المخاليط الغير متجانسة؟ شو أنواعها؟ What are the types? We have suspensions. We have thixotropic mixtures. And we have colloids. And homogeneous mixtures, we'll have a look at it later, okay? Like solutions, المحاليل, okay? So let's look at suspensions. So what is the definition of a suspension? A suspension or suspension is a mixture containing particles that settle out if left undisturbed. Settle out يعني ينزلون للقاع. If left undisturbed, إذا ما حركناهم. Okay? The mixture is a solvent and a non-dissolved material. يعني solvent معناها مذيب أو سائل مع مادة لا تذوب. Example of that is mud and water. So settle out means ينزلوا للقاع أو they stop moving, in another word, yeah. Okay, so if we put, so if we put mud in water, رمل في الماء وحركناهم بعدين خليناهم, بتلاقي إنه الرمل ترسب تحت, or it stopped moving, right? So this is a suspension. How do we separate them? We use a filter paper. Okay, we use a filter paper. Okay, if we put it, الفلتر بيمسك الرمل والمي or water will go through. Okay, so that's a suspension. What's a thixotropic mixture? Thixotropy is a property of certain gels or fluids. Okay. طبعا جل معناها جل. Okay, as you can know. That are thick under normal conditions but flow, become thin and less viscous. Okay, when shaken, agitated or otherwise stressed. شو المثال على هذا؟ Toothpaste, معجون الأسنان. So what's another way to explain thixotropy? Is when a solid-like mixture is stirred, it flows like a liquid. يعني لما يكون عندي جل اللي هو صلب لما أحركه أو أضغطه يصير يتحرك نفس السائل. مثال toothpaste. So toothpaste is solid, right? But when we press it or squeeze it, it flows like a liquid. Okay? Becomes less viscous. So that's a definition of thixotropy. Right? Now, for colloids, the last part of heterogeneous mixtures, colloids is a heterogeneous mixture of intermediate sized particles. يعني جسيمات متوسطة الحجم. It's a heterogeneous mixture. An example of that, or not an example, is milk. Milk is a colloid, but it remains dispersed. معناها الجسيمات ما راح تنزل للقاع أو تترسب نفس المي والرمل. No, it will stay dispersed. يعني بتظل منتشرة في المخلوط كامل. So this is the size of colloid particles between 1 nanometer and 1000 nanometer, and they do not settle out. عكس suspension. Suspension, they settle out. So milk is a colloid. So the components of a homogenized milk cannot be separated by filter paper. ما نقدر نحط الملك أو الحليب filter paper ونفصله. No. We need other processes. So solution has the smallest particle, colloid, متوسط, أحجامها متوسطة, and suspensions have the largest types or size of particles. Right? So there are attraction forces in colloids. في تجاذب ما بين الجسيمات في الكولويد, because it remains dispersed. ما it does not stop. So then the particles, they do not settle, they don't stop because they have polar or charged atomic groups on their surfaces. يعني مشحونة تكون. And that will lead to attraction sometimes, or forces, okay? في تجاذب ترافر. And the layers repel each other when the dispersed particles collide. So repel معناها تنافر. يعني يحصل فيه تنافر لما يحصل تصادم ما بين الجسيمات. That's why they will remain moving. And this is the figure you have in the book. في repulsion بعض المرات, في attraction. فبسبب هذا التجاذب والتنافر يحصل تصادم, فما تتوقف الجسيمات عن الحركة. They do not settle out. Okay? So the dispersed particles of a liquid colloid make jerky random movements. So هاي الجسيمات تتحرك على طول randomly بشكل عشوائي. هاي الموفمنت أو هاي الحركة تسمى the Brownian motion. So this is the Brownian motion. هي الموفمنت of particles in a colloid or a liquid colloid. فلازم نكون عارفين the definition. Okay? What's the Tyndall effect? So colloids appear to be homogeneous mixture. الحليب يبان كأنه مخلوط متجانس لكنه غير متجانس. كيف نعرف؟ كيف نقدر نعرف؟ ما نقدر نعرف بالنظر أو بالفلتر بيبر. So how can we know? We can know from the Tyndall effect. What's the Tyndall effect? اللي تقدر تقولنا إذا المخلوط colloid ولا لا أو غير متجانس ولا لا. It's using a light source. نحط المخلوط في كوباية أو في كاس. We put the mixture in a cup and then we turn on the light. If we cannot see no light, so here we can't see a light, okay? So if we can't see a light, it means it's a solution. If we can't see a light, it means it's homogeneous. If we can't see some light, as you can see here, it means it is heterogeneous. And that's the Tyndall effect. Okay? إنه الجسيمات scatter the light, or إن هي reacts with the light أو تتفاعل مع أشعة الضوء فتنشرها. Okay? تنشرها أو تبعثرها، تبعثر أشعة الضوء. Okay, الضوء. That's why we can see light here and here. Alright? So this is the Tyndall effect. شوف هني نقدر نشوف أشعة الضوء، هني ما نقدر. فهذا heterogeneous وهذا homogeneous وهذا colloid. Okay? Solutions never exhibit the Tyndall or the Tyndall effect. Solutions ما يبين لي أبدا الأشعة الضوء، فما ما يبان فيها Tyndall or the Tyndall effect. The Tyndall effect. Okay? Homogeneous mixtures are solutions, محاليل, depending on the type of the solvent. A solution can exist as solid, liquid, or gas. Solvent اللي هو المذيب. هذا الكلام كله مذكور عندكم في الكتاب في الصفحات اللي موجودة عندكم في الهيكل، مذكورة في الهيكل. Okay? So water is the most common solvent in liquid solutions. So معظم المحاليل يكون فيها المي هو السولفنت أو المذيب. Okay? So air is a gaseous solution. الهواء عبارة عن محلول غازي والسولفنت فيه هو النيتروجين غاز. المذيب هو النيتروجين. ليش؟ لأنه الهواء معظمه نيتروجين، هو أكثر كمية من الغازات الموجودة في الهواء هي النيتروجين. So that's why it's the solvent, right? So you should know this. إنه الwater is a solvent in the liquid solution and air is a gaseous solution and the solvent is the nitrogen gas. How can we form solution? We need a solvent, okay, اللي هو المذيب. So a substance that dissolves in a solvent is said to be soluble, يعني مذابة في solvent. A substance that does not dissolve, ما تذوب في solvent, it's called insoluble, يعني غير قابلة للذوبان. So sand is insoluble in water, لأنه الرمل ما يذوب في الماء. So sand is insoluble. Okay? Two liquids that are soluble in each other are called miscible. Okay? So miscible يعني نقدر ندمجهم أو يذوبون في بعض. Okay? It has to be a liquid and the liquid. Okay? That's the meaning of miscible. Two liquids that dissolve in each other. Okay? So two liquids, when we mix two liquids and they are separated or they do not dissolve in each other, يعني ما يذوبون في بعض, we call them immiscible. Okay? نفس مثلا الزيت مع الماء. They are immiscible. Okay? So this just shows you how a solution is being formed. You can have a look at the slide on your own. Okay? And we can go to question number 16. List the types of colloids and solution. اللي هو textbook صفحة 308 figure 3. So particles of colloid scatter light as we saw. And this is called the Tyndall effect. إنه الكولويد فيها ضوء. يعني لما نحط source of light الضوء يتشتت. So we can see light here. But in a solution no light. هاي الإفكت أو هذا الشيء اللي نشوفه هني is called the Tyndall effect. The beam of light scatters. Okay? So this is a colloid. لأنه في light. This is a solution. No light. And these are some types of colloids. Okay? هذه بعض الأمثلة من الكولويدز اللي عندكم في صفحة 308. وهذه أمثلة من solutions. So example air. مين solvent? Nitrogen. ومعظم السولفنتس أو المادة المذيبة معظمها تكون water. Especially in the liquid solutions. لأنه أنواع المحاليل محلول غازي, محلول سائل, محلول صلب. Okay? So you need to know these tables. You need to remember these tables. Okay?